Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about Jira dependency on advanced roadmap. Whenever we are talking about Jira dependency, this will indicate the relationship of one task to another in logical sequence. They help to visualize the order in which we need to proceed with the issues and estimates the time frame for them. Identifying and estimating dependency can be challenging, but so can be finding the tool that will help us to scale and project complex dependencies. So we'll see here how to manage dependency in Jira advanced roadmap. So here, for managing this, we have to navigate into the plan sections. I've already created the plan. If you don't know how to create the plan, please watch my previous video for Jira advanced roadmap. I will also include the URL in description so that it will be easy for you to quickly refer. So as I said, this is a manage plan page where we can see the dependency management. So once we'll apply the filter, we can see this dependency management sections. From here, we can also see all of the dependency report which is already generated. We can apply the filter based on our requirement. So if we want to create additional dependencies, we can just navigate into the dependency management, and from here we can add the dependency according to our requirement. So let's say I want to add the dependency here. So I wanted to add, so because here this is a review changes, I don't want to do it. Let's remove it. Not required. I wanted to remove this. Yeah, now this dependency has been removed. So if you can see here, if you want, we can add the dependency according to our requirement. So here we have old work, and now we can see this is the option. So block, parent of, so these options we can select it, and after that we have to select the other dependency. So let's see, I'm just adding more works. Click on this and this dependency has been added successfully. So now you can see this dependency has been added. So this is how we can add the dependency. And if you can see here, dependency report, we have this complex dependencies are available, but at any point of time we can remove it according to our requirement. So here we have basics, and whenever we'll click on this options, we can easily delete it. So this dependency has been removed, and the same thing will be applied on our dependency report. So as of now, we have just one dependency. Generally, by default, dependency in advanced roadmap use the blocks issue links type. In order to use custom issue links in advanced roadmap plan, they must be created and defined in Jira, then added to advanced roadmap. For configuration point of view, we have two steps. One is configuring our issue link in Jira. For configurations, we have to go to the issues, and then in the left hand side bar, we have to click on issue linking. So here we should have issue linking. Yes. Now here this option is on. If it is not on, we have to set it on, otherwise this will not show us to link the issues. If we can deactivate, we can also deactivate it. And these are the options for linking in issues or the permission set. These are the names which is available here. So here we have blocks, then clone, duplicate. These all the linking issues are available. Once we have activated, we can edit the name, outward descriptions, inward description, existing issue linking by selecting added on the column. So here, once we'll click on added, we have this options are available. So name should be available, outward descriptions and inward descriptions. Post that, we have to just update it, click on update, and this detail will be updated successfully. After that, after updating this detail, generally we have to go to the plan sections and we have to perform or add the dependency from here. When we want to add the dependency, just click on add and select the detail. Just add and navigate it to the other sections. block, and then now the dependency has been added successfully, and we can see here. So this is how we can add the dependency according to our requirement, and once we are done, save the changes, and this will be saved successfully. Now if we want to remove it, simply we will remove it from the roadmap sections. We can also have the options of deciding whether advanced roadmap uses concurrent or sequential dependencies. To do so, we have to just go to the configure, and from the configurations just select dependencies sequential, and here you have dependencies as sequential and concurrent. So this is how we can view, edit, and update our dependencies from Jira advanced roadmap. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. Let's recap. We have started with the introduction of dependency. Then we have seen how the dependency report will generate on advanced roadmap. Then we have edited some of the dependencies. And after that, we have configured dependencies to two ways. One with the issue linking, and second on the configurations of advanced roadmap. And finally, we have seen that how we can configure the dependencies as sequential and concurrent dependency from here. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.